Next, we want to get the Webflow form error and success elements so that we can show and hide those elements later down the road. We're going to do this by adding some custom attributes and targeting those elements based on those custom attributes. So for the error div, we're going to add the custom attribute data-form equals error, and for the success div, we're going to add the custom attribute data-form equals success. You can add custom attributes in the Webflow designer if you just go to the element, click the gear icon, find custom attributes. You can see I've already added data-form and I've equals success, and for the error element, I've already added data-form equals error. Now let me show you where in the inspector you will see those data attributes. So if we go to our form, we go up one, which is the parent element of the form. You can see it contains both the data-form success, so this is our success div, and data-form error. And you can see they're already set to a display none. Now, if we set those to display block, they should show. This will be the success div. Great, we've shown the success div. Now let's also show the error div. You can see just by changing the classes, we have control when we're actually showing and hiding those elements. Now, Webflow will always put these elements right below the form or inside the form's parent element. So in order to target those, we're gonna get to the email form, go to the parent element, which was the div that we removed the w-form class, and then query selector, the actual custom attribute that we want. And I've logged it here just so we can see it in the console. And we did the same for the success div. We went to the email form, went to the parent element, and then we query selected based on the custom attribute that we added. And again, I console logged it here. Now, I also want to set them to display none, just in case there's multiple submissions. We want to always reset it to the default state of display none. Now, let me just show you the logs of the error div and the success div, just to make sure we have them. Refresh the page. Console log. Okay, you can see we have our error div and our success div. We've successfully targeted them.